surround become shadows in the light of you. When I found the joy of reaching your heart, when my will becomes enthroned in your love, when all things that surround become shadows in the light of you,
in the light of you,
I worship you. Is to worship you. I worship you. I worship you. The reason I live is to worship you. Into your loveliness, when all things that surround become shadows in the light of you,
in the light of you,
I worship you. The reason I live is to worship you. I worship you. I worship you. Lord, I worship you. The reason I live is to worship you. The reason I live is to worship you.
In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
We begin today the season of Advent. It is a time of looking forward. We prepare ourselves for the day of the Lord. We are urged to be ready to welcome the Lord when he comes in glory. But at the same time, Advent also invites us to look back in history. The Lord has entered our history. And so, as Advent unfolds towards the latter part, our focus is on preparing ourselves to celebrate the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ, that great event of the Incarnation. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant your faithful, we pray, Almighty God, the resolve to run forth to meet your Christ with righteous deeds at his coming, so that gathered at his right hand, they may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the prophet Jeremiah. Behold, the days are coming, declares the Lord, when I will fulfill the promise I made to the house of Israel and the house of Judah. In those days and at that time, I will cause the righteous branch to spring up for David, and he shall execute justice and righteousness in the land. In those days, Judah will be saved and Jerusalem will dwell securely. And this is the name by which it will be called: the Lord is our righteousness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response to God's word is:
to you, O Lord, I lift up my soul.
All together.
To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. O Lord, make me know your ways. Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me. For you are the God of my salvation.
Our response.
To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. Good and upright is the Lord. He shows the way to sinners. He guides the humble in right judgment. To the humble he teaches his way.
Our response.
To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. All the Lord's paths are mercy and faithfulness for those who keep his covenant and commands. The Lord's secret is for those who fear him. To them he reveals his covenant.
Our response.
To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Thessalonians. Brethren, may the Lord make you increase and abound in love for one another and for all, as we do for you, so that he may establish your hearts blameless in holiness before our God and Father at the coming of our Lord Jesus with all his saints. Finally, then, brothers, we ask and urge you in the Lord Jesus that as you received from us how you ought to walk and to please God, just as you are doing, that you do so more and more. For you know what instructions we gave you through the Lord Jesus. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Kindly stand for the gospel.
mercy, O Lord, your mercy, and grant us your salvation. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "There will be signs in the sun and moon and stars, and on the earth, distress of nations, in perplexity because of the roaring of the sea and the waves, people fainting with fear and with foreboding of what is coming on the world. For the powers of the heavens will be shaken, and then they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. Now when these things begin to take place, straighten up and raise your heads, because your redemption is drawing near. But watch yourselves, lest your hearts be weighed down with dissipation and drunkenness and cares of this life, and that day come upon you suddenly like a trap. For it will come upon all who dwell on the face of the whole earth. But stay awake at all times, praying that you may have strength to escape all these things that are going to take place, and to stand before the Son of Man." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today, with the advances in communication, we are able to send images very easily. But earlier, this was not so. So if we had to meet someone for the first time, or we were going to pick up a person from the airport or the railway station whom we'd never met before, there would be an air of expectancy. Is this the person who I have to meet? And we would, for example, have been told the person is going to wear this particular outfit, or the person is tall. And then as each person passed by, we would be saying, maybe that's him, or that's possibly the person I have to meet, and so on. We would be waiting, but it was an active waiting. The season of Advent is a time of waiting, not passive waiting, saying to ourselves, okay, the Lord Jesus has promised that he's going to come. Now let's see what's going to happen. We're waiting for him. Oh, now it's getting a little boring. Let's do something else. We'll take a break and then come back to waiting. No. Advent is a time of active waiting, of waiting eagerly for the Lord, for his coming in glory, of preparing ourselves for the day of the Lord, when the Son of Man will return, as the Gospel tells us, in all his glory. In fact, in our opening prayer, we prayed for the resolve to run to meet Christ. That is the eagerness with which we want to meet him, to prepare ourselves to welcome the Lord. We run forward to meet him. What does this active waiting consist of? The readings of today tell us that two things are required: to watch, and secondly, to pray. To watch is to be alert, to stay awake. A person who is entrusted to be the watchman has to remain awake and alert and be ready to notice any sounds, hear anything that is different, and raise an alarm. When we are watching, our whole body, all our senses are engaged. We are watching and looking out to notice anything that's different. We listen attentively. Is there some movement? Is there something different that's happening? And so our whole being is engaged in watching. The Gospel uses signs to describe the coming of the Son of Man. And they seem to be frightful. But the purpose is not to instill fear in our hearts, but rather to shake us out of our complacency and to say, come on, be ready. The Lord is coming now. And so we are to take seriously the gospel message. We should not be afraid to meet the Lord, but rather eager and enthusiastic because the Lord is coming to save. Luke, in the gospel passage that we just heard, tells his readers to stand with confidence, to hold their heads high, because their liberation, their redemption is close at hand. In the first reading that we heard from the prophet Jeremiah, Jeremiah tells the exiles in Babylon that the Lord is going to deliver them and that he will be faithful to his promises, and Israel will now dwell securely in confidence. Watching for the coming of the Lord, therefore, builds up our confidence. It fills us with hope. Watching invites us to be courageous, to trust, because the Lord is faithful. As he says in the prophet Jeremiah, a righteous branch would be brought forth from the house of David. That is fulfilled in the Lord Jesus. The Lord is faithful to his promises. And so we wait, we watch eagerly, enthusiastically, we watch with our whole being. The gospel tells us to watch for the Lord's coming, but Luke also reminds us, watch yourselves. Be careful, lest your hearts be weighed down with the cares of this life. The cares of this world may engulf us and overwhelm us, and we lose our focus. We then remain unprepared for the Lord's coming. We become complacent, and slowly we possibly even slip deeper and deeper into sin. And we begin to think to ourselves, well, it's okay. No, Advent is a time to watch ourselves. Today, we are so conscious. We watch our weight. We watch our diet. We watch our fitness regimen. Should we not also watch our preparation for the Lord? Watch our spiritual condition. Paul tells the Thessalonians in the second reading, may he establish your hearts blameless in holiness before our Lord and God and Father. In other words, we are to watch our spiritual growth, to watch our growth in holiness and take appropriate steps. Active waiting, therefore, means watching for the Lord's coming and watching ourselves and preparing for that great event. The liturgy tells us of a second way in which we are to actively wait, and that is through prayer. We do pray during the season of Advent, and maybe we will step up and intensify our prayer. But Luke tells his congregation, stay awake at all times and pray. How can we do that? We have so many other things to do, so many other responsibilities and duties to be fulfilled. Can we pray always? Sometimes when we have too much of work, maybe we pray just when it's convenient. At other times, we have fixed prayer, time for prayer, when we dedicate ourselves to the Lord, when we commit and connect our lives to the Lord. To pray at all times, to stay awake and watch and pray, would mean to constantly be aware of God's presence. That even while we are carrying on our other responsibilities and duties, we are aware that the Lord is guiding us. That as we begin our work, we offer it to the Lord, conscious that we are connecting ourselves, that we are asking Him to be present with us in that particular responsibility. We constantly seek the will of the Lord in all that we do. So once again, we are connecting ourselves to the Lord. We are in prayer before the Lord. We need to discover what He wants of us, to be in contact with Him. Active waiting, therefore, requires us to pray earnestly, to pray sincerely, to pray confidently, so that we are ready for the Lord's coming. I invite you, my dear friends, to think during these days and plan, how am I going to intensify my prayer? What specific plan do I have to spend more time in prayer so that I prepare for the Lord's coming? With the psalmist, we say, "To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul." At this Eucharist, we encounter the Lord and we welcome Him into our lives. Every Eucharist prepares us for that great encounter, for the day of the Lord, when we will encounter the Lord in all His glory. And so we prepare through every Eucharistic celebration for that great event. Advent means coming. We are not waiting for a friend or welcoming a guest whom we are meeting for the first time, but it is the Lord who is coming. The Lord's coming is something that takes precedence over everything else. But as the gospel tells us, it will be sudden. The Lord will decide when He wants to come, when that day of salvation will arrive. He will come at a time when He wants. And therefore we are not to be afraid, because it is something we are looking forward to. We are not to be complacent, but rather prepare ourselves. We are not to be impatient. The Lord will decide when that happens. Our part is active waiting, to watch and pray. Let us now profess our faith in God as we recite the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Prayer of the Faithful. As we anticipate the coming of the Lord, let us turn to the Father in confidence with our prayers and petitions. Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer.
All together, Lord, hear our prayer. For the Church, that the season of Advent will bring about in her members renewed hope as we seek to live more fully for God. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For our world, that all people will seek equal justice for everyone and an end to discrimination of all kinds. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all who are gathered to celebrate the Eucharist today, that sharing the bread from heaven, we may have the fullness of life. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all the faithful departed, that they may know the joy of eternal life in heaven. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all those who are sick or housebound, that they will experience the healing touch of Jesus. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we pray for your blessings in this season of Advent as we strive to grow together in holiness and faith. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, we pray, O Lord, these offerings we make, gathered from among your gifts to us. And may what you grant us to celebrate devoutly here below gain for us the prize of eternal redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation. That when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Oh,
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a perfect sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again, until you come.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Oswald, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
We now make our spiritual communion with the Lord. O Lord Jesus, since I cannot now receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul, to enrich me with your holy grace, and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me, in the spirit of your holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, an abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O Sacrament most holy, O Sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through this spiritual communion.
Let us pray. May these mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray. For even now, as we walk amid passing things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and hold fast to what endures. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Prayer for relief from the coronavirus. Almighty and merciful God, who show your love to all creation everywhere, hear graciously the prayers we make for all those affected by the coronavirus in various parts of the world. We come before you asking for an efficacious control of the outbreak, for a healing of those affected, for the victims and their families. We thank you for blessing the efforts of our research scientists working on the development of a vaccine. We pray that these vaccines will be effective in combating the virus and its mutants and in controlling the spread of the pandemic and be available to all. We pray for doctors, nurses, and health workers who are in the front line of this battle, that they be kept safe and have the strength and courage to continue their heroic efforts. We pray for the government and health authorities that they take appropriate steps for the good of the people. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Say to us, I am the one who is to come.